And welcome back. Just waiting for that. We're in the Deerford Ruins, of course. We saw this blood pool. And these people have sacrificed themselves to gain some kind of power for revenge. What kind of power? I guess revenge against people who've wronged them. Skiing cultists this way. Alright, I'm not sure what it's all about. We couldn't get much of an answer from them. But we will attack this guy with range. I don't know why we're flying away like this. And then we will attack this guy with melee. And chunks will probably come out. No, I just fell over. He's using a club and not wearing very good armor, so.
Hello.
What was expect to happen?
Hello?
Kinda shut
Got
up.
Got it.
Oop, trap detected.
Back and off. The fire
Something new, yeah. Let's see if you can actually disarm this.
Shows me something new. That's settled.
Excellent. So I got experience. Didn't we used to get more experience than that? Anyway.
You can trust me.
I'm not sure what to think of you, Durance. So. Final Journal of Jonas and the Crypt's Master Key. This stone key has ancient engravings etched along its surfaces. The window's wider than I remember it being. My son, tomorrow I become the effigy. Okay, we're gonna find out what about that blood pool, I guess. Tomorrow I become Skeen's embodiment on Eora. Tomorrow my master chokes on his own whip. For months we met by secret conclave to plot our landlord's demise, all the while working the fields as if our heart were content. Skeen teaches us to plot with the mind while keeping one's face impassive, inscrutable. Fair fights are for those with armies. The quiet slave is our whetstone, our focus. In his worship, our cause finds focus, clarity, and possibility. Tomorrow my master chokes on his own whip. By the time you read this, I will be dead. I pray Skeen does not abandon me for speaking of my plotting, but a son deserves to know how his father died, for I have volunteered to be the effigy. Skeen will inhabit my body, using this old farmer's simple flesh as a puppet of godly rage. I have been shaved and anointed. Tomorrow morning I will be your father in name only, as my manhood will be removed. Damn. I think I've read this before, though. My nose and ears removed, and my useless mortal eyes will be replaced with flint stones to which Skeen might see the world. So I'm going to keep reading, because it's going to help us understand better what's going on with the blood pool. And plus, we're almost done. My son, I am sorry for the lies I have told you these past few seasons, but Skeen demands secrecy. Even your mother knows nothing of my furtive service to the quiet slave. Curse my name if you must, but never weep for me. For I die for the betterment of our community, to smite our lord's corruption from the face of Eora. Tomorrow my master chokes on his own whip, for tomorrow I become the effigy. Mm-hmm. Sorry, it doesn't work that way. Ooh. Yep, we have two, but that helps us understand the blood pool, as I said. This cabinet is finely crafted from a deep, rich wood. However, many of its shelves are broken from years of rough use. Skeenite scripture, which we already have. Oh. And two more. I'm gonna put these back in stash. I figured the game wasn't recognizing them, but it was. I'm not gonna keep the pat. The piglet. And what use is that to us on an adventure? Seriously. This is serious stuff here. What do we have equipped? Okay, good. Chunks. Chunks for that one. Fine scale armor. Initiate's hood. Great sword. And some copper. Small wicker statues with black stone eyes are placed between the flickering candles. Right, that's a thing that goes on when they do this. They replace their eyes with black stones. This is they don't have need for them anymore, like they said. We need to be sneaking. So it could be traps. See. Can I get away from that?
Yes.
Yes.
What?
See if you're gonna do that one. I guess if you can't do it once, he's not gonna do it. Repetition never seems to work. Okay, I'll have to go around this one. Oh, he almost tripped it.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Oh my god, another one.
And the fuck?
Can't I stop? He doesn't seem too bright, this guy, does he? How about this
one? Shows me.
Can I stop?
Something. New.
Hold up. That's someone else doing it. Kana was doing it. This is annoying.
What?
I guess I should have hired on a rogue instead of waiting for one to come into the story. Another. And a foe. What if we draw him out?
Hey.
Yes?
Trying to have everyone head this way.
Yeah.
Alright, let's have Durance draw him out.
What?
What?
There's a lesson to be.
Oh. As long as they don't run into that.
Yes?
No!
What?
Ah, getting close. She won't come through the trap, damn it. Aww. She sounded cute the way she did that. She's
yes?
Alright, we have to maneuver everyone around this crap now.
Yes? Of course.
What?
I'm close.
I'm ready.
Yes?
Hey.
I?
Eh?
Hey.
Let's sneak.
Quickly and quietly.
Yes?
What?
I'm ready.
Was this Aelys? Well, he's kind of in the way. I don't want people to run.
How may I help?
Around him.
I?
That was close.
Hey. Hey.
Eh? Got it.
Okay, now we have ranged temple guard.
Brave.
Boom, boom, boom. All the radiance. Next. Well, he's still kicking. This guy looks armed to the teeth, though. Blessing. Soul ignition on this guy. Boom. Not so bad when you just have them, you know, a couple at a time.
I'll see what I can find.
Look for hidden stuff. Oh yeah, like that.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Me neither. A scroll of fireball, nice. Still collecting this stuff. Haven't done anything with it. This elegant vase is cracked and chipped. It looks like an antique from Adir. Got a door here. Anything up over here? I'm just trying to be thorough. Any more secrets? No. Oh, unlock with Crypt's master key, huh? We still need to see what's across this bridge. And there's a way down. How big is this dungeon? Another pool? Oh. What's going on here? This is gonna be tough. Wymond? A large bull-necked man in a hood helps a young elven woman down from a glass chamber connected to a dizzying array of cables and machinery. Her skin and clothing glisten with fresh blood.
You may feel a little lightheaded for the next hour or two, but that will pass. Have a meal and get some sleep when you return to town. The transfusion.
The girl sobs into the back of her hand.
The transfusion will be smoothest if you relax and rest. The implanted essence already has a hold on your mind, so fighting it will be useless. And I hope our new visitor does not complicate matters overly.
He turns to you with a cold glare. What's going on here?
Subversion. The black sheep cousin of justice. Or haven't you heard Lord Heron's tale of woe about a missing daughter and an impending marriage? He's sent his soldiers to scour the village while he bides his time at the Dracogen Inn.
Oh, I've been saying it. Dracogen Inn. Dracogen Inn. So we found her. This is her. So what is she doing exactly? So what's her name? I forget people's names. I'm so bad with names.
You of all people should understand what I'm doing. I don't know who you are, but I can read that look of discontent on your face. Polite society frowns on your struggles and ideals as much as they do my animancy and Scan's rituals. But unsightliness reminds polite society that there are limits. When no one pays attention to the excesses and debaucheries of a lord, you give them something they can't look away from.
He takes a lock of the young woman's hair in one large, blood-smeared hand. Well, he knows we know, so I guess we don't act stupid. Haran said he was taking her to Aina's Rest, I believe it is called, to find a suitor, but a few pieces of his story didn't add up.
Did a bit of digging, did you? That's more than can be said for most.
Thanks.
Lord Heron's been telling everyone she's his daughter. He brought her all the way out here just to avoid anyone who might know differently.
What?
She's his niece, and she's carrying his child.
If that's true. Can we believe him? I mean, number one is like kind of skeptical. Number two is skeptical, starting to believe. Number three is completely believing, and four is skeptical. Why would he do that? He's horny. He has no moral values.
Heron's own wife's delivered nothing but Hollowborn. Now he's got no heir, and his sister's child, Aelys, is reaching the age to marry. Without progeny of his own, Heron's legacy would pass to her issue. So, he found a way to continue his own noble line.
Ugh.
By putting his child in this girl, his own niece.
Couldn't he have gotten a child by some other means?
Not a highborn heir. Even if he disposed of his own wife by some means, what family would marry their fertile daughter off to him? You can see the problem with this foolishness about blood and birth, I hope.
And animancy is part of your plan to destroy him?
This isn't just about Heron to the girl. It's about the corrupting influences of power and wealth. How people of privilege, people like Heron, are so often insulated from the consequences of their actions. The charged essence of dozens of maltreated slaves and underlings is already taking root in her mind. Once it's established, it'll drive her to murder her uncle, her aunt, and anyone foolish enough to get in her way. People won't be able to look away from Heron's sins then.
So this guy is just against power and wealth in general. And she's part of his whole plan here. So the charged essences of dozens of maltreated slaves and underlings. In that other room, the blood pool. Look at all this wire we've got reaching to all these points. Here and here. There. So she's got to have some kind of power from this. We can't let her just murder her uncle, aunt, and anyone else foolish enough to get in the way. Innocents will be killed. I mean, so what if they have power and money? Not all of them are bad. Nadara says, seems like a lot of trouble to go to when a simple lynch mob will do. They don't get a lot of things right, but this kind of thing they know what to do with.
I do not wish to destroy Nestor Herond. I wish to end his entire rotten line. His name will become a curse among strangers. The deeds of his house will be eclipsed by his ruin. Foes will hear his name and shudder with pity. And any relatives who should survive him will abandon their fortunes just to rid themselves of the association.
Okay, so is it his her story that has driven him to this? Or he has some personal stake in all this. Wipe Aelys's mind of the vengeful essence. Please don't do this. Fine, I won't slap you. I'll free Aelys from him. Yeah, let's see if we can do this. Wipe Aelys's mind of the vengeful essence. I'll free Aelys from him, and I'll free her from you too. You reach out to Aelys, seeking the dark crevices of her mind. The essence of 100 vindictive souls clouds her psyche, and you clear it the only way you can, by ripping out the horrifying memories to which they've attached themselves. It's taxing work, and some of the souls lash and sting at your mind. I can't believe these guys will all stand here and, you know, during all the time it takes us to do this. I mean, we're obviously concentrating for several moments, at least. Dozens of voices hiss in rage and despair. You work faster and faster, uprooting thoughts and images of a man Aelys once knew as family, as you tear through the tangles of memory, leaving the shredded remains to waft away and dissipate. You hear the sobbing of a lonely, scared girl at the middle of it all. So it's true. We found out in her mind. Too bad we didn't have the option to actually just probe her mind and see if it's true without doing this. But still, we can't just let her kill everyone. She's gonna rip through Deerford like friggin' Carrie, man. The uprooted souls turn on you in earnest, but you don't stop until you've severed the last thread of connection. When you finally clear the choking brambles of memory and fear, you retreat. You also feel the strain of your labors. Your head is pounding, and the slightest movement makes you dizzy with pain. Well, might not be in fighting strength. As these guys are going to be pissed. For just a moment, Elise's eyes close. When they open again, her expression is blank. But as she takes in the scene before her, you, Wymond, and the machinery in this strange dark room, her confusion turns to fear. She lets out a choked cry.
Kill them. All of them.
Uh-huh.
If she can't destroy Heron, then we can destroy his legacy with her.
He curses under his breath and turns to the other cultists. Uh-huh. So am I able... Concussion. I got a concussion from it. Zealous focusing. Okay. Oh wait, no, not off of him. I want to move him back. Why is he in front? We gotta, like, has our order gotten screwed up or something? Off of Adair. Boom on Wyomond. Boom. Boom. That's Aelys there. Holy Radiance.
Eh?
Getting hurt already. See if we can throw a light endurance. Okay, Aelys, do your thing. I can't cast it there. There we go. Consecrated ground. Oh, around the... around him, right? Oh! Theodess has been taken over. She's frightened, blind, and confused. Okay, let's throw him over here. See if we can throw that in. Her faculties are her own again. Let's see if we can cast this. I use Palagina's ability. Off of Adair. Speaking of Adair, well, we still got his knockdown in effect. Palagina, yeah. Hit him. I don't think she can get through there, so just... yeah, join the fight with this guy. Uh-oh. Knock someone down already. Did we get rid of him? I think we killed him. He's dead, right? Okay. Is that guy gone? Okay. Everyone in the sky.
That's it.
Theodis is back to she's back to enemy, and now she's ally again. Mindbreaker. Oh. I'll show you breaking. You break some stuff. Now you like them breaks. Oh, those are the breaks. Well, there's Aelys. The young woman blinks at you and takes a few steps back. Stay away. I don't know. She shakes her head and rubs her temples. What happened here? Could have used a voiceover from her, too. Skaenite cultists kidnapped you. She looks around at the dead cultists and pools of blood, her eyes widening in fear and confusion. But what? She winces and pitches forward, holding her head. We're not going to have a scanner's moment, are we? Hylia's wings! I can hardly remember a thing! She pauses, her brow furrowing. She mutters something in a dialect of Ruatai, then Valian. Ba nome. No. My name is Aelys. Her fingers dance at her side, plucking at the air in three repeated motions. Aelir. The opening notes of the false knight. Her twitching fingers brush her swelling abdomen. She looks back at you, a question in her eyes. It happens to the best of us? What, getting pregnant from your own frickin' uncle, I guess? You're a young noble who was taken advantage of by unscrupulous relatives. There's only been one of her past souls remembering. She nods absently. I also know I can't go back to the village, although I don't remember why. She looks around at the strange machinery, and I certainly can't stay here. The temple. Think the temple's safe? There's a temple on the edge of town. I'm sure the clergy will help you find some place safe. The suggestion sinks in slowly, but it seems to take root in the newly barren places of her mind. It's good advice. She takes a final glance at the blood-spattered chamber. I won't look back. She hurries away. Poor girl. My god. Now Aelys... consecrated ground is going insane. Cables snaking along the floor and across the ceiling connect to a glowing glass chamber. What do these guys have? Exceptional morning star. Blood blessed skein cultist robes. Probably read that. Is it the same as this? Yep. So then, yes, I'd say I have read it. Got a key. Wyman's key. This key is made of polished bone that feels surprisingly sturdy despite its light weight. I love that even each key has a different description. Awesome.
Let's see what lies this way.
Before we finish the episode, I'll finish looking at this chamber. See if there's any secrets. Thick liquid bubbles inside the tank, releasing a pungent scent. Motes of essence swirl in the mixture. Unlock with his key. We have Atuk, unique dagger, one-handed. Plus 10% of hits convert to crits, plus 5 accuracy, plus 8 accuracy, plus 30% damage. A blade of Inutinic origin, Atuk, skinning knife, was a gift passed from mother to daughter, used to remove hides from various hardy creatures of the tundra. It is precisely designed to pierce vulnerable joints and cut deeply and cleanly into flesh, making it a fearsome weapon against less traditional game as well. None of us use daggers. Alright. And even if I get a rogue, I can have him use anything. There's no restriction. Wyman's notebook. The looping scribbles are difficult to read, but as you flip through the pages, you can make out several passages. Near the beginning, you read, "Will be a suitable place for my experiments. There's an abundance of space, and, more importantly, the locals are content to ignore it. I could probably construct..." You skip ahead several pages. "Willing volunteers. The legacy has brought many grievances to the surface, and capturing the essence is primarily a matter of timing. The ritual of the effigy serves as a good template for..." You scan the middle of the book. "Died, and their essence evaporated. Next time I'll have to try a smaller concentration of the reagent, too." Turn to the last page. "Noble from Defiance Bay. Aelys. Results were mostly consistent across the other subjects. The challenge is always applying the method to an unwilling participant, but her situation may prove an advantage. If I can bring those memories of her uncle to the forefront, it might render her essence more susceptible to the process." Oh, crap. Alright. Let's finish up by looking around for any secrets. And anything else that we might be seeing. Which isn't anything, actually. Alright. Well, Aelys ran out this way. I'll have to fix my grouping. Hold up. Yeah, what the hell, man?
Slowly now.
I don't know why these moved. I know, we're getting late to this episode. I'm just trying to fix this. Okay, there you go. That's what I want. I like Palagina near the end in case someone sneaks up on us, but that never seems to happen. So, thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.